number of different ways by which grass might be cut, and one method might be deemed more suitable than another, when one takes into account the terrain that needs to be cut. For large fields, the tractor is employed and makes light work of it. For a beautiful front garden or badminton court, a lawnmower is brought out. And what is becoming increasingly heard is the strimmer, that can easily reach those awkward areas in the vineyard, or where the ground might not be level. A scythe, while being the most labour-intensive method, is also the oldest and quietest, and one feels a particular connection with the past in using it. Not only that, but it has a rhythm entirely in harmony with the environment, and the rasp of a whetstone, heard in the valley or from a neighbouring field, is a sound that can connect you with some latent sense of your own origin. Cutting grass, in order to do it well, requires a considered balance between precision and rhythm. It takes a great deal of practice to align the body correctly and angle the blade to just skirt the ground. And with a little effort, lay a swathe of grass in a neat and satisfying row to one side. Here we are taking instruction from our good friend Damir. And here is how it should be done. He manages to make the task seem deceptively effortless. And when we watch him from a distance, he seems so much a part of the scene he occupies that we can recognize his image as if it were a page from a medieval manuscript. Summer, and Bara returns from her meadow each morning with enough freshly cut grass to feed her one cow for that day. Elsewhere, the villagers take to their meadows, and for a few hot days there is a wealth of activity to cut, turn, dry, and collect the hay with the tractor and cart it back, each to their own barn. In the surrounding fields we see Tichomir and Biba. In the valley we find Mika. And in our meadow, Torna and Maritza. But for some, the art of cutting grass is nothing they ever need think about.